Hello everyone, I am Dr. Aparna Sharma. I am Additional Professor in the Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology at All India Institute of Medical Sciences, New Delhi. Quality improvement science is very relevant to problem solving in our day-to-day clinical experience. And we would like to share one such project that we carried out using the principles of quality improvement to bring about improvement in the quality of care for our patients. We work in a tertiary care center of India where about 400 patients visit to the gynecological OPD per day, and 40% out of them are coming for the infertility treatment. So with the limited infrastructure, resources and low staffing with high volume of patients, the quality of care delivered is compromised, leading to the long waiting period for investigations and for follow-up appointments. We look into the chain of investigation the patient has to undergo for the infertility treatment. In the first visit, history will be taken and baseline investigation advised. In the second visit, hormonal profile will be done on day 2 of the menses, and she'll get the date for endometrial aspiration in the next menstrual cycle. In the third visit, her EA will be done and she'll collect the report of EA after 15 days in the fourth visit and gets a provisional date of around 3 months waiting for HSG. The patient will get the confirmed date in the fifth visit. HSG test will be done in the sixth visit, and she'll get the report in another visit and meet the doctor for further planning. So it takes minimum of around 6 to 8 visits, accounting for 6 to 8 months for all the investigations and treatment initiation. So for looking into the problem of long waiting time, a multidisciplinary QI team was constructed comprising of a consultant, a junior and a senior resident, along with a nurse. Baseline data from 10 consecutive infertile women was collected, with the average waiting time found to be 6 to 7 months. Root cause analysis was done for people, place, policy and procedural aspects, and it was found that the date for HSG is given only after seeing EA report, and HSG test is done only once a week in a 2-hour slot in the radiology department fluoroscopy room. So we aim to decrease the waiting period for initiation by 50% in 4 weeks' time, with PDSA cycle 1, in which the date for HSG was given on the day of EA, and PDSA cycle 2, in which the slots for HSG were increased from a 2 hours to whole day. With this, it was seen that the PDSA cycle 1, there was 51% reduction in the waiting time, and also the shift in the baseline was seen in the run chart diagram. Consequently, after cycle 2, it further reduced to 70% with the average waiting period of just 2 months, and the results were sustained even after the last PDSA cycle because the change were changed in the system. Implementation of any change idea is not without its own challenges, and various problems were faced during the period of the study. It took significant convincing for the nurses to combine the dates for HSG and EA, as it was perceived that it would increase the workload significantly. However, after the initial few slots, it actually decreased crowding as 2 visits were being combined together. Also, increasing the time for HSG from 2 hours in a day to 6 hours in a day meant increasing the cases from 10 to 15 to almost 40 per day. The logistic requirement for this presented a challenge in terms of the number of instruments required for doing the procedure and the staff who would be doing the procedures for the whole day. For the former, some more instruments were indented with the cooperation of the sister, which was easily available in the hospital store. A rotation of the staff posted in HSG was agreed upon between the gynecology and radiology department for the smooth conduct of the procedure. Also, the duty roster of the residents doing the HSG was shuffled so as to accommodate a full day of doing the procedure. Despite these challenges, with persistence and good interdepartmental coordination, the proposed changes could be achieved with desirable and sustained results within the constraints of a resource-limited settings. In a resource-strapped setting, it is often felt that patient care cannot be improved within the limitations of an existing infrastructure and resources. However, a closer look at the problem with methodological problem analysis and targeted solutions can bring about a significant improvement even in these settings, as was witnessed in our project. We would like to conclude that with a well-organized and conducted QI project and team efforts, the required changes can be brought about in an established conventional healthcare delivery system, and the improvements can be sustained over a long period of time. Thank you.